the Jedi Master Kenobi Eve, ladies and gentlemen, Gungans, and thank all you good-looking droids out there across our beloved empire. We are mere moments away from the Jedi Master Kenobi Galactic Legend, but no details in regard to the exact time it will be released. There will be an update tomorrow, and Master Kenobi will be here. Be sure you're ready to party here in the Kyber Cup, because let me tell you, we got a lot of stuff planned out for your entertainment for tomorrow's Galactic Legend stream. But until then, we got a big update. It just hit the game. We have some big quality of life. It's been a while since we had some decent quality of life changes that we got to break down here, but we got some scary news here. In this update, we got our first teaser of Relic 9 coming to Galaxy of Heroes.
Hey kid, come here. Do you like free-to-play hero collector games that have amazing graphics? Hundreds of characters to collect, millions of players?
Well then let me introduce you to our sponsor today, Raid Shadow Legends.
I mean, don't just take my word for it. Look at how much Barry loves Raid Shadow Legends.
One of the absolute best things of Raid Shadow Legends are the variety of bosses you can fight, each with their own challenges, strategies, and rewards to progress your roster. And I want to talk about one of the most challenging dungeon bosses out there, Fyro the Infamous, or as we all know him, the Fire Knight. Fyro was once a proud knight of Volkar, but he committed regicide at a peace summit with the Frost King and was bound by his own people to guard Volkar's treasures.
But how do you get access to those guarded treasures?
If you're gonna take down the Fire Knight, I recommend champions such as the Arbiter, Allure, or even Athel, who have abilities that can do multiple attacks to allow you to take down the Knight and claim what is rightfully yours. And you gotta come play Raid Shadow Legends this month, because they have many more brand new champions on its way, with a bunch of summer events, and on top of that, a new rotation of the Doom Tower.
I have another great champion that you can get for free if you scan my QR code or go to the links down below in the video description.
And if you're a new player, you'll be getting an epic hero, Chunaru, 200,000 silver, 1 XP booster, 1 energy refill, and 1 ancient shard.
All this treasure will be waiting for you right up here, but you gotta be quick because these rewards are only available for the next 30 days. Oh, all right. I got a little breather. Let's talk about this update.
Before we talk a bit about Relic 9 here, there's two important things that is coming with this quality of life update. You might already see it in your Google Play Store or your iOS Store. It's going to be here within the next 24 hours at the most. For you guys, if you are not seeing it right now, we're going to take a look. I do have the update installed on my Imperial Tactical display over. But two things, squad management tools, as well as a feature that helps you understand if synergies are being activated in team, which I like, but I have some feedback for Cap Games to make this even better so newer players can get an understanding of how synergies work inside Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. So let's take a look at this first. Relic 9, come on! Oh, squad tools, organize your roster faster than ever with the new squad management tools. You will notice that the character ship inventory screen has received a visual update. Definitely a nice change for 2021, and we have added several new tabs on the left-hand side to assist you in finding and arranging your squads. Now, before you get too excited, yes, there's some squad management changes they made, but they haven't added fleet management stuff, or what I should say, saving a fleet. Like how you can save a squad so you can easily access it, click and go. Doesn't look like they have it yet, but they kind of have the bare bones or what they can maybe add sometime in the future. Well, and this is interesting right here. I need to see how this works in application once I have it installed on my free-to-play account over here. But they have this new feature which looks like it should help you if you're like a player that's not watching YouTube or going to Reddit, going to forums, or have a friend that can kind of guide you. They're gonna have this tool that kind of gives you recommendations on what to do based off your roster right here. Learn what to focus your resources next with the recommended tab, which provides squad recommendations based on your account and journey guide progress. You can also find initial and advanced squad suggestions for each character in the game by tapping on the new info button on that character screen. So here we go. We have a little bit of an example where, can I just zoom that in again? Where we have the Kenobi Relic 9. popping up here again. I'm going to hold off. I don't want to get too freaked out just yet. I'm going to give you guys a little bit of hope that maybe this isn't coming anytime here in the future. But as you see right here, check out the journey guide for General Skywalker full requirements. So it's kind of interesting. I have the update popping up on my free-to-play account as we're speaking right now. But some people are not. It's hard to believe, but there is a segment of the population that is not on YouTube, not on Twitch, not on the forums, not on Reddit, that just casually plays this game and might not know the best the farming paths or what teams you can possibly form. This looks like it might be a nice addition for those type of players out here. Moving on, create new tabs to organize your squads right from the inventory screen. Easily move, rename, copy squads to other tabs with the tap of a button. You can even add units that aren't unlocked to help you plan for the next event or your newest squads. And another thing, no big mod changes per se, but you can view the mods your squad currently has by tapping the show mods toggle in the squad screen. Another quality of life update that is vastly, drastically overdue is some mod management. Luckily, third-party tools out there exist that make it a lot more manageable. However, it would be nice if there were in-game ways to make those mod changes happen. And here's something I really want to talk about a little bit more in depth. I think this is big, but I just want to show some feedback that we can make this even better potentially. The leader synergy indicator. This update also adds a leader synergy indicator to the pre-battle squad screen. Now you can quickly determine if your squad's leader abilities partially or completely applies to the rest of your squad members or even unassigned units in the pre-battle squad screen. Let's pause there for a moment. We'll come back to the last part. Last part's nothing all that drastic here, but come on over here real quick. So here's my free-to-play account that we are currently on. Firstly, it doesn't really show me anything. Oh, it's reloading. All right, let's give it a second to load it up. There we go. So I think this is actually quite interesting and nice. A lot of times people don't know what the best squads are. Like, what teams can I make inside of my roster? Well, this is the first time I clicked on this, and these are pretty logical things. One famous Wookiee, it's showing me we got Boss, Boba Fett, Jango Fett. Even though I have Cad Bane to 7 stars, it's not even bothering of Cad Bane. They're like, dude, you're gonna have a lot easier time if you use Dengar Mandalore. This is not trash. That is actually good. If you wanna go after that one famous Wookiee, Ray's Journey, here we go. We got Scav Ray, we got BB-8, so it kinda shows you the progress that we're making towards that Mandalorian Journey. Legend of the Old Republic, we're making some pretty fine progress towards that. This is actually kinda nice. Credit Heist, this is great. I didn't have to do anything, and it already kind of gave me some blueprints to work off. Now, of course, I might go above the beaten path a little bit and do something a little bit different, but still, for someone that maybe is not exposed to things like how I rank all the squads in the game or creating journey farming guides for all you guys, no matter what farming path you go down, I give you a blueprint so you guys know where to go. This is actually pretty neat. Big props to that right here. And then here's our defaults right here that we've created by myself, but I like this recommended tab that they created right over here. And the next thing I want to talk about here is this squad synergy, not suggestion, but squad synergy overview. They got a good blueprint going on here, but this is not the beat on Capital Games. I'm not saying your game's like, it's important to keep your eyes open and your ears peeled for how to build upon a good blueprint you have and make it even better. We're waiting for the update here, but so we're going to hop over to Conquest just for the time being. It should load up my first order crew, which, by the way, we've been doing great for this second run of Conquest on the free-to-play account. So here we go. It shows us the leader ability here. Squad receiving the following synergy buffs first order. And as you see here, it shows that, yep, we're good here. We're good here. So let's say I take first order Special Force out and put in Ezra. Boom. It's showing that there is no squad synergy activated. Let's take this to the next level, shall we? And again, this is not the beatdown Capital Games. I hope they understand that it's good kind of getting feedback from other games. They might not know about this, but Marvel Strike Force has had this for a while, and I've been a huge fan of this, especially when synergies and kits start getting more and more complicated. It would be nice for people that don't understand synergies. You should see how many times I'm on a stream, people are like, wait, what just happened there? Because there's some minor clauses or synergies that maybe people aren't seeing the connection with here. So here's an example for Marvel Strike Force. Actually, let's pull up a different team. Let's pull up the Black Order, one of the best teams inside of Marvel Strike Force. Where'd I put you? Boom, right over here. So here's an example right here. Ignore the left-hand side. The left-hand side icon's basically the mods. It's a lot better than Galaxers, but we want to pay attention to the numbers. As you see, these numbers activate, which means it's showing there's some synergies, an X amount of synergies happening between all these characters. I'm not going to read them all right here, but as you see, it shows you synergy number one. There's with Titan Eternal, a unique ability on Thanos. It's showing what happens when Ebony Maw is paired with Thanos here. Then here's another one of Cole Obsidian. You have another several forms of synergy happening there. Then we got Proxima Midnight. So this is great I think Galaxers is on the right track with starting this up, but showing that, hey, your leader ability is affecting X, Y, and Z characters. But it would be great if it showed what exact clauses are synergizing with certain characters. Maybe there's some synergies you didn't even realize that were happening there, and it would say, hey, there's some synergy, let's just say, between Veers and Grandmaster. Probably not really, but imagine if there was some unique ability to kind of synergize well. It's a lot of work, of course, but I just want to put it out there. I highly recommend we try to get something like this going, because again, there is a big segment of the population that is not playing Galaxy Heroes on a very narrow, very laser focus base by being on all the social avenues out there that exist. It would be great kind of having these things so people can click on it and say, wow, I did not know these guys synergize that way. Let's hop right back over to the forum post here. Lastly here, this update also features this update also adds a few features to the search tool. The primary change that you can now tap highlighted faction tags when looking at a character to go to a filter, to a filtered view of that faction in the inventory screen. Second, the advanced guild search now allows you to toggle between including and excluding full guilds and advanced search results. Nothing incredibly big at this part, but I like where this is going. Recommended teams, I kind of like that. I'm hoping we get some more mod changes, quality of life overhauls sometime down the road. And hopefully they also allow us to create a saved squad functionality for ships. Good start right here, but let's take a brief moment and talk about this. Gungan in the room, Relic 9, as we see again right over there. Now, initial reaction, you guys know me. One of my most consistent opinions is I am not a fan of when we get new gear increases, new mod increases. It would be nice if we got an increase to the mod inventory. That's a separate point. New slices to the mods or new relics. Mainly, my biggest issue is that we don't really make it easier to catch up on previous gear grinds, etc., from the years in the past. If they would do something about that, I would be less of a pessimist when it comes to this. But let me give you a little sprinkle of optimism here. This could be an accidental reveal. I think Relic 9 is coming sometime. How long? Hard to say. Remember we saw a trailer way back when that showed new mods coming to the game, the new mods that we just got not too long ago. It took them about a year or so to finally get that implemented in the game. So yes, although we're seeing it, I do believe this is coming at some point in the future. Is it going to be next week? Is it going to be a year from now? Hard to say, but I think within the next year for sure, we're probably going to see a Relic 9. But the rate things are going, we might see a Relic 9 a lot sooner in the future. And who knows? We're waiting for the next Galactic Legend down the road. Relic 8 is fairly new. And as you guys know, Master Kenobi is already acquiring 2 Relic 8s. Imagine if Relic 9 comes soon. I feel like I can almost guarantee you that if Relic 9 comes in the next month or so before the Jedi or Lord Vader requirements start coming up, that's the predicted Galactic Legend coming soon. Relic 9 might be needed soon. And again, I wouldn't mind Relic 9 as much if they made it easier to get access to things like Relic 8. So, oh man, a lot of stuff to soak in. Great changes here. Glad to see that there's some nice recommended features in here. And this is a lot more streamlined. It's a lot more up to date with 2021. A few more things in here would make it perfect, as I kind of showed you here a few moments ago. Relic 9, we're going to have to see what is going to be around the corner, what is in store for the future of this, because as you see, Relic 9 is not yet featured inside of the game, but I think it's bound to happen sometime soon, as we're seeing. So until then, ladies and gentlemen, get excited, get pumped. Let me tell you, we are all hands on deck here at the Kyber Club Studios, the next installment of the Arnold Cinematic Universe coming out tomorrow. Cannot wait to stream Jedi Master Kenobi with you all. So be sure you stay glued to the channel, and I'll keep you guys up to date when we will stream, when we have better indication on the exact time. Like, comment down below, and all your thoughts. And be sure to subscribe so you're not missing a thing. And just say it with me, baby. Dang, it's great to be in the Empire today. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Peace out.